Do you recall the doing any of the red and white multicolors?
Yeah, I painted them.
Do you feel like you did fewer of them than the other colors at any end?
Oh yeah. We never did. I never did very many of them. It was just special orders, you know.
So not many of the red and white went out.
No, not that I know of. Not while I was there, anyways.
Red and white multicolor, in my opinion, is the most rare of all Rogers finishes, only mentioned in the 1954, 56, and 57 catalogs, and only swatched in the 1957 catalog. This finish was discontinued by 1958 when the 59R catalog was printed and published. The only drums cataloged in this finish were drums that made up the Mercury outfit, which were the Mercury snare drum, the Mercury bass drum, and the Mayfair tom-tom. Notice here in the 59R catalog that the color is no longer an option for these models, and on the back cover the swatch is no longer present. I enjoy my entire collection of these red and white Rogers drums, which consists of two Mercury snare drums, one Mercury bass drum, one 9x13 Mayfair tom-tom, and lastly the drum I want to discuss today, this 1957 Holiday snare drum. In the 1954, 1956, and 57E catalog, the Holiday snare drum is only offered in three colors: white marine pearl, black diamond pearl, and gold sparkle pearl. And in the 1957 catalog, though red, blue, green, and silver sparkle, as well as Mardi Gras, are added to the Holiday snare drum finish options, there is no red and white multicolor or any lacquer finishes at all, for that matter, that are ever a catalog option for the Holiday model. Lacquer finishes were applied to specific models, such as the Broadway, Classmate, Mayfair, and Mercury. This drum is without a doubt, in my mind, a customer special order. The drum wears tall hoops in the first year of their production, 8 flat top coffin lugs in the final year of their production, Eagle Badge, Holiday Tag, and Universal Strainer. Side note about the strainer really quick. As pointed out to me by my friend Gary Nelson, in catalogs of the 1950s, this strainer is marketed as the orchestra throw-off and has the straight lever, like this. Animations in the 57 catalog start to show the twisted lever version of this strainer, but it is not until the 60R catalog, which was published in 1959, that this same four-point strainer is marketed with the twisted lever and called the Universal Throw-Off Strainer. Just an interesting tidbit I wanted to include. Back to this drum. I want to mention the tone control. This drum is factory drilled for a tone control that I have never seen before. I say it is factory drilled because there is white paint from the interior being sprayed in the holes drilled for the tone control. This tone control has very similar mechanical features as a Leedy tone control that I have seen, and also a Gretsch tone control that I have seen, but it is indeed neither of these tone controls. I had suspected maybe Wahlberg and Auger, but pretty quickly learned that it is not theirs either. Then my friend Alan Fogel sends me a picture of this drum, which has no maker's markings on it and has the identical tone control. Very interesting to me. I'll quickly tell you an abridged version of how I acquired this very unique drum. It's quite different than most of my experiences. It's a long story, so I'll edit out most of the details to save time. A few years ago, when I really started to seek out these red and white drums to see if I could even find any, a friend of mine contacted me and said, "Hey, I had one of those drums a while back. I think it was a Holiday. I sold it to a friend. Let me get you in contact with him." He gets me in contact with his friend who had also sold the drum. This friend, whose name escapes me at the moment, says to me, "Let me check my records to see if I could find who I sold it to. I greatly appreciated that." He gets back to me and says, "I sold it to a guy in Canada named Joe Valella." I track down Joe on Facebook and contact him. Joe and I have since become dear friends. Joe says, "Yes, I had the drum, but I sold it a couple years ago to Maxime Lalonde." Maxime Lalonde is a well-known touring Canadian drummer. I asked Joe if he could contact him to see if he can get the drum back. Mr. Valella reaches out to Lalonde, but he is difficult to contact because he's always on the road, etc. I stay in touch with Joe and check in periodically regarding the drum. About a year later, Joe video calls me and says, "Let me show you something." He pulls out the drum. He had gotten it back and graciously sold it to me. Thank you, Joe. A two-year quest comes to fruition. To me, finding this drum is a lesson in patience and perseverance and never giving up on searching for a drum that you think you may never find. There's an even crazier story about how I found some of those other red and white drums, but that's for another day. I hope you guys enjoyed taking a look at this very interesting drum. Thanks for watching.